Hello everyone, in this video we are going to look at Huffman coding. The question is, a source with alphabet A, B, C, D, E with respective probabilities being 0.15, 0.05, 0.25, 0.35 and 0.2. We have to calculate the standard Huffman code, minimum variance Huffman code, average length and variance for both codes, and then draw the binary tree for both. Okay, so first we are given that A, B, C, D, E have probabilities 0.15, 0.05, 0.25 and 0.35. Okay, now first thing is arrange them in ascending order or descending order. Okay, if you are arranging them in ascending order, then you have to write from bottom to top. If you are arranging them in descending order, write from top to bottom. Okay, so I have 0.05, 0.15, 0.20, 0.25 and 0.35 in ascending order, right from bottom to top. So 0.05, 0.15, 0.20, 0.25, 0.35. Okay, now for standard Huffman code, add the below two numbers, the numbers that are two below. So 0.15 and 0.05, when we add them I get 0.20. now let us find this 0.20 in this probabilities. So 0.20 exists, so I have to write it just below that. Okay, so and others will be copied as it is. So 0.35, 0.25, 0.20, and this addition gives me 0.20. I'm copying it here, and this will be written as 0 and 1. Okay, now let's move forward. Again, last two probabilities will be added. So 0.20, 0.20, this is 0.40. does it exist? No, it doesn't, but then it is the highest value here. Okay, so we will take it to the topmost part, and then remaining will be copied as it is. Okay, just slanting one down. So I have 0.40, 0.35, 0.25. Next, again, add both of them. 0, 1 gives me 0.60. Now this is more than 0.40, so it will go to the highest part. 0.40 comes down, and finally I have 1. Okay, now we have the symbols and their respective probabilities. Now let us find this code word. Let us start from the bottom most, that is B. Okay, so coming back, B, when it starts, it's from here. Okay, so B traverses this length, goes here, then moves up, comes down, and then this is how it finally reaches 1. So 1, then when it came here, okay, sorry, 1, when it came here, again 1, then it moves up, nothing, 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 and again 1. Okay, so I have 1, 1, and 1. So the code word of B is 111. Now let us find for A. So for A, we have 0. Okay, it starts from here. Then it goes here, so 1. So 0, 1. Then it moves up and then comes down. This is the path, and it reaches 1 again. So 0, 1, 1. So 0, 1, 1. We'll write it 0, 1, 1. Okay, remember you have to write from the backward side. Next, for E, we have 0. And then 1, 0 and 1. From backward side, it's 0 and 1. Then for C, C again is 1, okay, if you traverse this path, and then 0, 1, 0. So backward side will be 0, 1, okay. So I have written it wrongly here. It will be 0, 1. Oh, sorry, it was right. And then finally D, it is 0, so we are traveling this path 0, and then again 0, okay, 0, and then again 0, so we have 0, 0, okay. Now code word length, that is the number of code words. So we have 2 code words here, 2 code words here, 2 here, 3 here, and 3 here. Now let us find average code word length. Average code word length is summation from I equal to 1 to k, p of k into l of k. L of k is nothing but my code word length, okay, and p of k is nothing but my probabilities. So let's write it down. 0.35 for this first probability, it is 0.35, code word length is 2, so 0.35 into 2 plus 0.25 into 2 plus 0.20 into 2, 0.15 into 3 plus 0.05 into 3 gives me the answer of 2.2 bits per symbol. Okay, now let us find entropy. Entropy is nothing but probability is multiplied by log base 2 1 upon p of k. So to write log base 2 in your calculator, it's just below this on button, this. So you have to write this base 2 here, and here you have to write 1 upon whatever probability is there, so that is 0.35. okay, and it needs to be multiplied with 0.35. so 0.35 multiplied by this, okay. And similarly you have to do for everything, since it is a summation, so for every probability you have to find it like that. The final answer is 2.121. this is entropy. Now let us find redundancy. Redundancy is basically mod of h minus l bar. H is my entropy, l bar is my average code word length, gives me the answer of 0.079. okay, this is my redundancy. Now we have to solve this same question using minimum variance. So the only difference in minimum variance is that the addition that we were doing, that doesn't go below but it goes up. What I mean by here is I have this symbols and their probabilities. Add the last two, I have 0.15 plus 0.05 gives me 0.20. now this 0.20 won't go here below the available 0.20. it will go to its place, okay. So this goes here and this comes down. Previously what we had done, we had written it here and this was written here, okay, but now it will go up and the remaining one will come down, okay. And then again 0.20 plus 0.20 will give me 0.40. it is highest here, so it will go to the topmost part, and then 0.3 others will come down, and then 0.35 plus 0.25 gives me 0.60. finally addition gives me 1. Remember, this answer should always be 1, otherwise your question is wrong, your solution is wrong, sorry, because this is a probability and sum of all the probabilities need to be 1. Now let us find the code word and code word length. So we have symbols, probabilities. To find code word, let's start from B part. For B it is 1, okay, then it is 0, and then it is 1. So 1 0 1, okay, 1 0 1. Then I have A, 0.15, okay. So for A it is 0 0 and 1 0 0 and 1, so 0 0 and 1, okay. Now for E, it is 1 and 1, so I have written it 1 1. So finally, after writing all of that, I have code word lengths here, okay. Remember, see this code words, 0 0 0 1 1 1 1 0 0 1 0 1, okay, it was different previously. The last two were 1 1 0 and 1 1 1, okay, it's different right now, okay. Now find the average code word length using the same formula, and entropy using the same formula. The entropy will remain same. Finally, redundancy, mod of h minus l bar, and efficiency, that is h upon l bar. Now this is not asked in the question, but still you should know the formula. It's h upon l bar. So h is my entropy, l bar is my average code word length, gives me the efficiency of 0.964, which is nothing but my 96.4% efficiency. Okay, so what's the difference between normal standard Huffman code and minimum variance? Minimum variance will give you the minimum value possible, the maximum efficiency, okay. And your standard variance may have a bigger value as compared to the minimum variance, okay. So always remember that whatever answer that you are getting for minimum variance, that is the most compressed answer you will ever get, okay. It's like Huffman code is used for audio compression, text compression. So the maximum compression will be given by this minimum variance method. Thank you. See you in the next video.